अस्सलाम वालेकुम, दिस इज उमर फारूक खलील अहमद, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स ऑफ GM Women's कॉलेज भिवंडी। आई एम हियर विद द सेकंड लेक्चर, लेक्चर टू फॉर थर्ड ईयर BSc मैथ्स 3 ऑफ द चैप्टर 1 मैट्रिक्स स्पेसेस। इन द फर्स्ट लेक्चर 1 we have seen the definition of metric space and first two examples. Let us consider the third example of metric space. Before that, we see what is the definition of metric space. A metric space is defined on a non-empty set X. So if we have X a non-empty set, and then D from X cross X to R is said to be a metric which satisfies four conditions. The conditions are the positivity, then dxy is equal to 0 if and only if x is equal to y, dxy is equal to dyx, symmetry and triangular inequality, dxy less than or equal to dxz plus dzy. We have already seen these conditions and the definition. Let us straightforward go to the third example, Euclidean metric space. What is a Euclidean metric? Euclidean metric means our distance formula, which is here given. When x is Rn, then d from Rn to Rn, Rn cross Rn to R, defined by dxy is equal to e square root of summation of xi minus yi square, summation taken from I from 1 to n, where x and y belong to Rn. It means they are n-tuple, so x is equal to x1, x2, up to xn, and y is equal to y1, y2, delta z, to yn. So x and y are in n-tuple. This is called as Euclidean metric. We will show that this is a metric. It satisfies all four conditions of a metric. So the first condition, if you see the first condition, non-negativity, xi minus yi is square. Being is square, this is always non-negative. And if I take x1 minus y1 square, x2 minus y2 square, plus x3 minus y3 square, then summation of all the terms, the summation will also be equal to, will also be non-negative. So it will be greater than or equal to 0. And then its square root, positive square root of non-negative term is greater than or equal to 0. But this is dxy. So we are getting this distance, Euclidean distance, dxy is greater than or equal to 0 for all xy belonging to Rn. This is the first condition. Now second condition. Second condition is what we start with, dxy is equal to, by definition we have this. Okay. But in square root I can change this, instead of xi minus yi I can write down yi minus xi is square, because it is square. So we can easily change that. There is no harm in that. And then there is no changes over here, but this is the definition of dyx. Okay, so this is dyx, and x and y are not fixed. This is for all x and y belonging to Rn. So dxy is equal to dyx. Second condition also is satisfied. Third condition, dxy is equal to 0 if and only if I take if and only if, then this is, by our definition, dxy is this Euclidean metric. So we have this is equal to 0 if and only if this term is 0, this is square root of some term is 0. When I take its square, then it will become like this, summation of xi minus yi square is equal to 0. When summation of this square is equal to 0, then these are all non-negative terms. Okay, none of the term is negative. Therefore, if summation is 0, then each term must be 0. Each term of this summation must be 0. So this if and only if we have xi minus yi square is equal to 0 for all I from 1 to n. And if this square term is 0, x1 minus y1 square is 0, x2 minus y2 square is equal to 0, then each term is 0. And that will follow, or if and only if xi is equal to yi for all I. When it is for all I, it means x1 is equal to y1, x2 is equal to y2, x3 is equal to y3, like that. It means the n-tuple x1, x2, x3, xn, this n tuple x1, x2, x3, xn is equal to y1, y2, y3, up to yn, it means x is equal to 1. So what we got here, this if and only if x is equal to y. This is the third condition. Actually, this is the second condition I have written third. Dxy is equal to 0 if and only if x is equal to 1. Come to the fourth condition. For the fourth condition, to show the fourth condition for Euclidean metric space, we need to use one inequality, which is known as Minkowski's inequality for real numbers. What it tells? It tells us that the pth root of summation of pth power of alpha I plus beta I is less than equal to, if we separate these things, means pth root of only summation of pth root of mod of alpha I plus pth root of summation of mod of beta I is to p, that is the Minkowski's inequality, which is useful over here. So, but we are going to use this with p is equal to 2. Okay, let us see how we use it. So the first thing we have to start is with the given definition. Dxy is equal to summation of this is our definition. Okay, then we have one adjustment again over here. We can subtract and add zi. So we get the next term like this. Summation of xi minus zi plus zi minus yi. These two will get cancelled. These two will get cancelled. Okay. And we are actually getting the same thing. Now, this xi minus zi bracket term can be taken as alpha I. And zi minus yi bracket term can be taken as beta I. And we can use this. So we will separate. When we separate these two terms, then we will have a less than or equal to. So see what happens. We will have here the next term as dxy is less than equal to this term, which is alpha I, and this is beta I. Okay, and p is 2 here. So by Minkowski's inequality, the previous term follows this. It is less than equal to this. But left hand side was our left hand side was dxy. It is less than equal to, this is Euclidean distance dxz, this is Euclidean distance dzy. That proves the fourth inequality, which is triangular inequality. So this distance dxy satisfies all four properties and it becomes metric on Rn. And Rn with this is known as Euclidean metric space, which is one of the most important metrics. Come to the fourth problem, fourth example, which is also very important, discrete matrix space XD. If X is any non-empty set and we define a mapping D from X cross X to R as DXY is equal to 0 when X is equal to Y and this is equal to 1 when X is not equal to Y, this is known as discrete distance or discrete metric. It shows that distance is 0 when X is Y and distance, the other value, the only other value of the distance is 1 when X is not equal to Y. Okay. So by definition itself, this distance is either 0 or 1, so it cannot be negative. So it follows directly that DXY is greater than or equal to 0 for all X, Y belongs to X. Coming to the second condition, if we write DXY is equal to 0, we have if and only if X is equal to Y, because it is defined like this only, that DXY is 0 when X is equal to Y. So this can be, because it is the definition of discrete matrix, so it can be considered as if and only if. Then third condition, DXY is equal to DYX, we have to prove. So we will have here two cases. If X is equal to Y, then by definition of discrete matrix X is Y. When X is Y, DXY is 0. So DXY is 0. And when X is Y, Y is X. Therefore, I can say that dyx is also 0. Therefore, dxy is equal to dyx. Okay. Secondly, when x is not equal to y, then by definition, when x is not y, distance is 1. So, dxy is 1. But I say that when x is not 1, I can say y is not x. When y is not x, then I write dyx is equal to 1. So, I'll have dyx is equal to 1. Okay. So dxy is equal to 1, which is equal to dyx. So in both the cases we can see that dxy is equal to dyx for every x and y belonging to x. Third, to prove the fourth condition, that means the triangular inequality, we have to take different cases. When x is equal to y is equal to z, means all the points coincide, then by definition of discrete metric, when x is y, dxy is 0, when y is z, dyz is 0, and when x is equal to z, dxz is 0. So we will have dxy 0 is equal to this 0 plus 0, equality will hold. Okay, it means in triangular inequality, equality holds. So it is true. Second case, when x and y and z, all of them are distinct, then dxy is 1, dyz is 1, because y is not equal to z and x is not equal to z. So x is dxz is equal to 1. So every term is 1. So I can write down, I know that 1 is strictly less than 1 plus 1. So this one is dxy, this is dxz, this is dzy. So a strict inequality holds in triangular inequality. So in the first case, equality holds. In the second case, strict inequality holds. These are two cases. We can have two, three more cases. One of those is when x is not equal to y, but y is equal to z. Then x is not equal to y, distance will be 1 by definition, and y is equal to z, the distance of z and y will be 0. Okay, and y is equal to z, and x is not y, so x will not be equal to z, so x dxz will be equal to 1. Okay, so if we try to write down what happens over here, this 1 is equal to this xz plus zy, so 1 plus 0. So we have dxy, which is 1, is equal to dxz plus dzy. Again, equality holds in the triangular inequality. So considering two, three more cases, x is equal to y, but y is not equal to z, and y is equal to z, but x is not equal to z. These two more cases we can consider, and we can see that like this, either equality will hold or strict inequality will hold. So in all these cases we can see that we can prove that the triangular inequality dxy less than equal to dxz plus dzy for all xyz belonging to the set X holds, and therefore this is a metric space which is known as discrete metric space.